everybody.
Hi.
How's
Hi.
Everyone doing?
Hi.
Good.
Good.
Glad that you guys came. So we're here to talk about and work on Fedora badges. I see a few people who might have already done some or a lot with badges. Yeah, I'm Marie Norton. I've been working on badges for about 4 years.
And I'm Masha, and I've been working on badges, I don't know how long.
And this is?
So I'm Kanika. I'm contributing to badges for about 1 year.
What else? Oh, did you have something, Jen?
No, you should move in a little bit.
To the mic, I guess.
So first we're going to talk about badges just a little bit, and then we're going to run through a quick tutorial, and then we're going to get everyone set up to go, and then we're going to pick out tapes and start working. So if everyone's ready, let's jump in and do this thing.
Yeah.
All right, so obviously designing Fedora badges is fun. We do it as a fun part of Fedora to bring more contributions in. And here's our blog where we talk about our work.
Okay, so let's look at the badge itself, and I'm just gonna go over here. That's okay, do I have to take this thing? Okay. So I'm sure you've all seen a badge, and if you have not seen a badge in your life, just put your hands up. So the badge constitutes five different things. There's an outer ring, with a drop shadow, there's a colored ring, and there's a background, a pattern, and a graphic. And what you need to know about this one is that the colored ring and the background change from badge to badge, and there are different categories, and we are going to get to that in a bit. And then the graphic is the fun part, actually, that you get to design.
So an important note here is that all badge designs will have all of these elements. So whenever you're designing a badge on your own, you want to make sure that you have each one of these elements in your design. All right, so this is what the website looks like. We have a profile for each person. Has everyone logged on and seen what their profile might look like? Yes? Okay,
yeah.
Cool. So you can see history sections. It's broken down by the 6 different categories.
Okay, so recently we've moved to Bagger, which is new and exciting, and we're very happy to be there. And then the other day I was trying to remember what Fedora hosted looked like, and I was so happy we moved to Bagger. And I'm sure you've all guys seen Bagger, right? Yeah, okay. Well, the good thing about it is that it's new. First of all, it's new and shiny, and it's beautiful, and the UI is beautiful, and I love using it. And then it has tags, and so you can sort your badges right now, and also you can add images, just directly upload them into your tickets, which is so cool. And there's more stuff, and I guess we'll just have to see.
Okay, so there's design resources for designing badges. So before you start designing badges, you want to make sure that you have all these, and when we get to that point, we'll make sure that everyone's got them. But there's a style guide, so that's something very helpful that you want to reference while you're designing to bring your design in with the aesthetic of the rest of the badges. Although we have many different artists working on it, we do have a general look and a feel that we want to go for, and there's just a few different tips that you can learn from the style guide that will help it kind of feel cohesive, because obviously there's all different kinds of art that can be made, so we want to kind of keep it somewhat streamlined. We have templates for you, there's palettes, so that's another thing that helps the aesthetic stay together. We kind of use the same colors throughout the whole set of badges. And there's content, which Kanika's gonna talk about momentarily. There's some very exciting stuff going on with a symbol library. So we'll get there.
Go back for a second?
Yeah.
Just FYI, there's a tutorial with all the links that you might need, and I've provided a little teeny tiny URL for you or this QR code, so you could just go ahead and kind of do that in the background if you want, or if not, we'll get to that later.
Does anyone need this up for a minute? Do you have the link? Are we good?
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, go ahead. Okay, so if you go to Tiger and go to put our badges right there, there are a couple things we need to know. So there would be a list of badges, and Marie here did triage and she categorized all of them. And if you are designing your first badge, what you want to do, you want to go for the artwork easy kind of badges with the artwork needed signed by it. So basically these badges will have the full description, the artwork concept, and you just need to go in and kind of draw the badge, and that's it. Super easy. You want to add something?
Oh, all right. Do we need to switch to?
I think we can go through the yours right now.
Yep.
I'll just drag it over. Again, we're gonna do a quick one for the single library. So you can go ahead
away.
And I can switch your slides when you want.
So hi, I'm Kanika. I recently started contributing for making badges. I used to use Inkscape for making badges. So I thought of working on a new project. It's a small project called Symbol Library. Symbols are basically the pre-made SVGs that are saved under the tag symbol in SVG files. So the new release of Inkscape 0.91, they have a new feature called Inkscape Symbols Dialog. So it will help you to make your own symbol library, and you can use it anywhere in it's very easy to install a symbol library and use graphics as a symbol. So a symbol library is a document which consists different symbols under the tag symbol. Each symbol tag is a complete symbol itself. So when I started working on badges, the thing that I used to feel that the resources are scattered. They used to be in zip file, but it was I was a bit lazy, so I need to go to the zip file, unzip it, and import a single SVG. So I used to find it a bit time consuming, so I thought of collecting them under a single library using the symbol feature that was introduced in 0.91. So to reduce the efforts of using resources which are made with so much of hard work by the design team, I thought of going forward with this project. So how does it work? You need to download one SVG file which contains all the graphics as in the form of symbol. Then you need to install it. Install it as in there's a folder.config in your home directory. You need to go to the Inkscape folder under .config, and then you need to make a folder called symbols. Under that folder, you need to paste the downloaded SVG file. Then you need to restart your Inkscape, and then you need to open the symbols dialog box. Or you can just press Shift Control Y, and you have to drag down to the new symbol library, like Fedora's graphic library, and you just need to click and drag the graphic for using them. So you don't need to, you will see all the resources present for the design team which has been given by design team in the same dialog box. So you need not switch screens for seeing different graphics. So it's very easy to use. What are the different libraries already present in Inkscape? So there are five basic libraries already present: map symbols, logic symbols, the mail symbols, dot symbols, the flowchart, and the word balloons. So these are the basic libraries. So we thought of coming up with Fedora library. It will contain Fedora characters like badgers, pandas, penguins, these, and the Fedora graphics which design team has made, like the flag we have. And the beakers, what other graphic other than graphics other than the characters and backgrounds. So these are those are Fedora batch graphics and simplified backgrounds. So since symbol is a new feature, symbol dialog is a new feature in Inkscape, so it's not that stable. So it cannot support complex graphics to be converted as symbols. So right now we are planning to add just simplified backgrounds or the simple backgrounds that can be converted to symbols easily. So we are making one library which contains all these graphics for simplifying the Fedora batch making process. So advantages of this library can be, like, there are advantages. So you can make badges faster. Symbols can be named. So now you must have noticed, if you have made the graphics, the badges, the graphics, sometimes we don't understand that what the graphic is. It's like, if we use them, they will be looking good, but we don't know what the name of it, or we are just confused what does it represent. So in symbol library, we can add a description to the symbol, which can make it easier for the contributor to understand what the graphic is about. Symbols can be edited. So the resources we have, these are SVGs. So it can be like edited very easily. So the symbol, they also can be edited. So there's no restriction of editing it. You can go to edit in Inkscape, select the symbol, edit, clone, unlink, clone. So it will convert the symbol into a group. So you can edit it easily. There should, in Inkscape, there is a bug for symbol edit, like editing a symbol. There should be an option under objects for converting objects to symbol and symbol to object. But there is a bug, so it has not been activated right now. It is being worked upon, and I think next release will be fixing it. So now it's a fallback and fallback option to edit symbol using edit, clone, and unlink clone. So disadvantage of using symbols are, so I have shown a picture like Fedora symbol. It was a symbol. I used this procedure to convert it into a group. Now I can edit it as much as per my wish, as per my needs. So these were the advantages. Disadvantages are, symbols are like pretty new, as I said. So they are not well tested. Sometimes what happens, when we are dragging, clicking and dragging a symbol, if the graphic is too complex, when we converted it to symbol, the Inkscape document crashes. So it's like, you need to be very precise in making symbols sometimes, because if you make a symbol out of an object which has lot of groups, it will be complex and it won't be converted to symbol easily. Or if it is converted, if you use it later on, the document will crash. So it's a disadvantage. Very complicated SVGs cannot be converted to symbol. You will try to convert it, but it won't be converted, and it won't show any message that it has not been converted. So it's a disadvantage. Another disadvantage, so if you have a graphic which uses gradients and shadows, so these, when you convert them to symbol, the gradients and shadows will be disappeared. Either they will be like, it will be completely empty, or the gradient base color will be given to the graphic. So the gradients and shadows doesn't work right now for symbols. So these were the disadvantages for this library. But I think Inkscape, this is a new feature, so Inkscape community will be working on it, and will come up with the fixes for this. Yeah, so I have made this repository and figure. I'll be updating a few SVGs there. You can go and visit it. Right now it's not been updated. And I would like to thank Masha and Mary and Ms. Mo for helping me and coming up with this project. Thank you. If you have any doubts, you can ask.
So this is a project that you are starting now, and you want to improve in the future to make it easier for us to produce some new badges.
Yeah.
Is it? Because we went to the Pedro repository, and for the moment there is no files. It will come. Okay.
Very exciting.
Okay, so now we're going to do a design tutorial. So we're basically going to run through the steps that you want to take when you decide on creating a badge design. So we're going to go through quickly, but then we can kind of go step by step with everyone, and myself and Masha and other people who are experienced will help you guys individually. It's gonna go quickly. Don't worry if you think it's going too fast. We'll come and help you guys all individually.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay. Do I need to click?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Okay. Yeah. There you go. So first of all, what we're gonna do, and again, we're gonna do this in a second. We're just going through. So first of all, you download all the all the resources and install them. So there will be a font, there will be a tool that you could use. There will be a couple of SVG files that you can drag around. That's it, right? And then we'll help you select a ticket that you can work on. And then you can take it, assuming that you are in the design group. Or if not, we'll add it you to the design group. Or you don't have to take it at all. I mean, it depends on what you want to do. And then download, identify ticket, and set yourself to owner, and then you're good to go.
All right. So once you've chosen a ticket, and on the tickets that are marked as artwork easy, there should be a concept there. You are going to want to look at similar badges. So that will help inspire your artwork for the badge you're creating. This is good because, once again, it helps it stay cohesive, and you can grab elements from those badges to make your artwork. There's a lot of reoccurring themes within the badges system, so it's nice to kind of reuse and mishmash what we already got going on. It's a great jump board for everybody. So from there, you can gather inspiration using a search engine. You know, you can see what other designers have done. Say you want a bicycle. The one that I think we're doing is a package delivery we're using as an example here. So we decided we wanted a badger on a bike with a package. So I just, you know, Googled guy on a bike, and I grabbed a package, and I grabbed a badger from a previous badge.
Except that's what you always want to do, because try to draw a bike from your mind right now. It probably will be buzzing for a bit, but if you just Google for an image, there you go, you don't have to think that. Okay, then the important part starts. Now listen up, there is a style guide, right? The style guide is what you want to look at first, because there are categories, like I said, so all the outer rings are different colors and the background are different colors, and that's why I need the style guide. So you want to go in, you want to identify which category your badge falls under. For example, it can be a community, or it can be development, right? Or it can be content. And if you're having trouble with that, you can always ask, right, Marie or me, or Misa or Mary over there, and then we can help you categorize your badge. So please use the style guide. And also it has some very good rules on how to keep the badges consistent. So for example, the outline should be rather thick, you know, and stuff like that. Okay, and then there are templates for each of those categories. So you go in the style guide, you see what your badge category is, and then from the resources, you open the particular template. Now, you don't want to change the template. The template is perfect, so it's the perfect size and the perfect place, so when you export a PNG, it would be like the same as other badges. So that's what you want to do. So you open your template in Inkscape, and then you save as and pick your own name. And usually what I recommend is picking up the number of the ticket and the date you're working on, or at least a year, right? And that will help you organize your files in your computer. Okay, and that's it for this one. And by the way, this is the link to where our resources are right now.
All right, so the next step and the next layer of your badge is gonna be the background. So In the style guide, we have subcategories broken down for each of the categories for the background colors. Now, I'm going to admit that this is not as updated as it needs to be. There have been a lot of new badges since this was made originally. So you also want to use the Explore page on Fedora badges proper to get some reference for the background. So for example, under community, like we have a lot of member badges. So if you're a member of sysadmin or you're a member of the design team or et cetera, you have a pink outer circle and then the background of your badge will be green. So that's just one example, and there's plenty more of those. So those badges, the background colors, you can find on the palette, or the Fedora badges palette, which we'll install and help you set up.
Okay. Alright, so you have your template open, just new category. The next thing you can do is, having looked at the similar badges, you might want to grab one of the patterns for your background. Or I don't know, you might create your own even, right, if you're feeling particularly creative that day. Or you can just grab one of those. So I like the waves, I like the rays coming out, which is sexy. That's one thing you can do. And then, save.
That's important.
Definitely.
All right, so the last and final element of your badge design is going to be graphics. So you can mix and match stuff that already exists. You can build your own, which I can show you guys as I go around, like a few tips and tricks to making and using Inkscape, making objects. So you basically want to jump into that, and this is where the real drawing part comes into it, but luckily there is a lot of artwork that's pre-existing which you can work off of. So you wanna, once you kind of have a draft, you wanna use the style guide to evaluate it. So what are my strokes, the stroke on the object looking like? Is it very thin? Maybe it's too thick? So that the style guide will give you a reference for what that should look like. Also, am I using the right type base? We use Comforta in most cases, unless it makes sense with the concept to use something else.
Mm-hmm.
And then once you're satisfied, you want to export a PNG. And if you're using that template, it should be exactly the right size. And then you save and, you know, export. And I think the next page is going to tell us, what's this?
Oh, that's about the tiger.
Oh, right.
Okay, so I think the point was that you might want to download artwork. Okay, so if you come to a badges ticket and you see that somebody has been working on it, but it's been like half a year or more since they touched it, you should probably assume it's safe to take it. I mean, you can ask in a comment, like, hey, do you mind if I work on it? If they haven't touched it for a while, it's probably okay. And this slide is about Tiger. There are some slight issues after migration, and so files might not always be visible. So usually you could come in and download the SVG from there, because you can attach it right into the ticket. But sometimes you would see that the link is not working, and then what you want to do, first of all, so this is the URL coming from Fedora Hosted, and you want to replace this part with the Tiger part, right? Or if it looks like this already, but still not working, you might want to get rid of those files, of the slash files before.
It's kind of a workaround for a bug for Peugeot.
So
we wanted to review it with you guys.
You
might have the need to download previous artwork, and this is the workaround to deal with that, because images didn't come over perfectly.
So the problem is that I'm working on removing the files, but I fixed the issue in Hubs.
Okay.
But the problem in Hubs badges is that whenever I try to do a migration, it creates a third command.
Okay.
So I did it in one of the issues, and it created a third command. With the proper, it shows the proper image in there.
Okay.
But then we have the other two also present there.
So we'd have to manually delete them?
Me and Pingu are trying to figure out what's the issue in there, but it might take some time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Thanks for the update.
For sure.
Okay, so once you have your artwork, you then want to upload the SVG and the PNG to the ticket. Now, it's really important that you upload the SVG because we all know how life goes. You might get distracted. You might not be able to finish the badge, and that's totally okay. But uploading the SVG, the source file, will help any future artist come along and be able to work on it. Also, if it's exporting strangely and you're not sure why, then one of us, the mentors for this project, can jump in and take a look and see maybe what's going on with that. So actually with Peugeot, you can just drag and drop the files right into that comment box, say, hey, what do you guys think? You could even comment me, Masha, Mismo, Mary into it and say, hey, what do you guys think? That will give us a direct, like, hey, this person's working on this actively, so we'll come in. And then you update the issue.
Well, and I said press preview just to make sure that both your files are uploaded.
Mine just pops up. I don't even have to.
It does. Press preview.
Cool. Okay. So press preview. Don't see what happens. then.
Okay, once you've done that, so if you've mentioned one of us, you're probably most sure to grab our attention. But if you really want to talk to some of the Badges people, then you can just hop on to Fedora Design Channel on IRC. Or you can even... No, don't email.
No, you can email me.
You can email me.
You can... Masha might know our emails, but you can email me. I'm on IRC a lot less frequently. I have a separate full-time job, so... I'm not online all the time. So
IRC me, email her.
Yeah.
That's how it works.
Yeah.
And then, so for the badge to get pushed, you need it to be approved. And that's what we can do, right? So we'll set artwork to approve, and then get it pushed. So that's what we want to do.
But before that, we probably, unless you're like totally amazing and great at it, which is definitely a possibility, we'll probably want to work with you a little bit to improve the design, just so that it fits in with the badges a little bit more, so you can expect some reviews and critiques, but it's, you know, all in the good name of our beautiful designs. So once it's all approved, then we say, hey, developer, come by when you can and push this out. That's it. That's the whole process. Who has Inkscape on their computer right now? Does anyone not have Inkscape? Okay. Does everyone have design resources? No. Okay. So first thing we're gonna have you do is go to Peugeot, the Fedora badges, issue 528, and you can find the resources there. So